I think because of what he's doing on this record, it's a storytelling record, and it's really a tone setter in terms of setting the scenery for where we're going to be residing for the rest of this album. The music fits perfectly. It's very dramatic. The strings are just like they're going all over the place.
Yeah.
It's a very dynamic piece of music. It
escalates too.
Yes.
Yeah, very dynamic.
It's not like a standard loop. It's a piece of music. There's a certain
feeling of... It's that audio cinema that you speak of.
Yeah, audio cinema, especially in the lyricism and some of the, you know, some of the lyrics, which are very picturesque, I must say. Very detailed, you know, it's some great writing.
So yeah, this content, basically, like you said, the structure of it is kind of skipping to different points in his story and his come up, you know. So verse one, well, it kind of starts in like the present day, but by the end of the verse, he's flashing back to the beginning of his childhood. So, you know, look, mind state of the gangster from of a gangster from the 40s meets the business mind of Motown's Berry Gordy, you know, moving along, you know, America meet the gangster Sean Corey. Hey, young world, want to hear a story? Close your eyes and you can pretend you're me, you know,
going hey, on world, and on about Slick Rick.
Yeah, you know, yeah, it's Slick Rick reference, you know, cut from the cloth of the Kennedys, Frank Sinatra having dinner with the Genovese, you know, this is the genesis of a nemesis. So yeah, and he finds a way to transition, you know, this is a tale of lost innocence into a time where he was innocent, you know, as the incense burn and the turntables turn and the Al Green plays, I see my mother's afro as my mama taps her toes as she rolls at J's. My papa just left the house in search of the killer of my uncle Ray, you know, going through all of that, you know, basically ending with, you know, she's
he puts
nurse,
dude he puts you right there he puts you right
you're
there,
in the room with him,
like, yeah, just like a fly on the wall, like watching this all go down. The tension is palpable for sure on this song. The imagery is top notch. It never fails to bring me to a place.
Yeah, it brings you to a place each time. It's to use that word that's overused. It is, it's vivid. It is, you know, it's, he puts you right there and, you know, he imparts.
And I feel like there's also some
upon you
musically, some level of tension and release between that constant, almost anxiety and dread underneath the beat, and then the coda of pray for me, you know,
pray for me. Yeah, you know, I mean, he makes it clear, like, all this happening, as I observed, this is just one day. It's like, yeah, this is the life of a young Jay-Z. All this is happening just one day. That's crazy, you know. You know,
and it keeps up with that concept of, like, it feels like we're in for a story album, a concept album.
Yeah. Yeah, he pulls that off. Luckily, like, I remember hearing it back in the day, like, you know, not only watching the VH1 Storytellers, which he was breaking down the songs as he was, like, you know, as he's rapping them, but also hearing it, you know, just the album itself and being like, oh man, all right, I'm in for a ride. Okay, here we go, Jay-Z, y'all. Like, it's, you know, so he moves along to that verse two. So we start out present day in verse one to then childhood by the end of the verse. And then verse two, it's a little later, you know, early maybe preteen age, you know. He's just like, as I head to my homeroom, I observe the ruins, dope needles on the ground. I hear cargo vroom, vroom dealer in the BM.
No,
yeah, cargo vroom,
you hear it, you know, 360 around, like in the
that sound
in the
design,
headphones.
Bro.
Like, there's it's some great. Really dope sound design in this verse.
You know, drug dealer in the BM with the top down. As the girls start to giggle, I ask why you laugh. They say you too little. One day you'll understand when you become a man about things you have to get you. Fast forward, freeze frame on my pistol.
There's like this rewind sound. Like
the, fistful of dollars, ignorance is so blissful. So, like, listen, clearly he took that to heart because now here he is in the future.
Yeah.
Hey, like, fistful of dollars. These are the things he observed. These are the things he grew up. The girls, they like that. They giggling, you know, they like it. I want to be just like the dealer in the BM with the top down. You know, they told him you'll understand it one day. So, like, yeah, by the end of that verse two, it's like a young hustler, Jay. And then, you know, verse three is kind of just talking about the concept, you know, of dealing and living that life as a
whole.
He
plays
you
off
know.
That Kanye bar off of Graduation, everything I'm not,
everything
made me
I see,
everything I am.
Yeah, sweet taste of sin. Everything I seen made me everything I am. Bad drug dealer or victim, I beg. What came first, moving chickens or the egg? That's why I be so fresh. I'm trying to beat life because I can't cheat death. I like that one.
What about aiming stainless is at anuses?
Well, that's just good violence. You gotta love that. And, you
move
know, of
Coke
course,
like Pepsi, kind of referencing the movie American Gangster.
Yeah. You know, cocaine, y'all.
And gotta of course,
it, I think. I don't
he's
know.
He's talking about, it. Like, Pepsi. I stand behind that.
Yeah.
I guarantee it.
That's what Denzel says in the movie. It's a brand name, you know?
Like Pepsi.
Like Pepsi. Yeah, exactly. You know, of course he ends, I'm not an angel, I'm sure, but every night before I lay, I drop my knees to the floor and I pray. Gotta love it, you know? That's just to the record, you know?